Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about our baseline express template with the TypeScript, which we are going to use in all other microservices. Okay, so we have already designed a simple architecture where we are going to create a Nginx containers, MySQL, Node.js container, Redis, all these containers. But first we should baseline our express TypeScript template or NSJS template, which we are going to use across different microservices as a baseline template. So our baseline template should have all the features, like npm run build. It should have all the scripts. It should have a proper linting configurations, compiler configurations. It should have a Docker file, Docker ignore file. It should have a proper test cases written. So if you do npm run test, we should be able to execute the test cases which are already available, and we should be able to create the coverage. So you see NYC coverage will be generated whenever you do npm run test. Okay, similarly we have other scripts which are just doing a typeorm migration. So typeorm is a library which you can use with Node.js to write the migration seeders and creating database, dropping database. All these utilities are available. It's like a Spring framework for Node.js, where you are actually like Spring Hibernate we have in Java. Similarly, this typeorm is a library which is helping you to deal with the MySQL connections, inserting, updating, deleting, or creating the relationship between different tables. Here we are defining the entities for our MySQL. Like if you see in our migration, here we can write our create table script. Like for user, it is there. In the app, we can see our migrations and services. Okay, these are the models and entities. So this user entity model representing a user table. Here we have an email, username, first name, last name. So I have already covered how to work with typeorm with Node.js. If you are interested in learning, you can actually look into that. Okay. So we should be having a proper API spec created. Okay, using Swagger, so we can actually expose the API definitions of our APIs. Either we are writing a REST based platform or a GraphQL based platform, we should be able to expose the API definitions which we have written. We should have a Docker file .env file, for populating the runtime configurations. Either you will be using .env or some other module. Okay, so in .env you will put into the gitignore file so that you will not end up pushing these runtime configurations into your GitHub. In package.json and all, here we are writing orm config where we are specifying the entities directory, migration directories and all. This is required for our migrations and seeders to run. Another thing is a nodemon.json. We can run this server by just after compiling node server.js, or we can use nodemon, and nodemon is using tsnode to run TypeScript file on the fly before even compiling. Either you can compile the TypeScript to .js and run the server, or you can use tsnode, tsnode dev to actually run the code on the fly. Tsnode dev will actually keep watching the files. Okay, so this is what we have. This is the baseline template. Have all the different features. It has a tslint configurations, all the different rules. So if you are going to violate and you do tslint, npm run lint, you will get a proper errors. Okay, why this linting is breaking currently. Okay, these are the different extensions we are using: tslint recommended and consistent style, clean code strategy. Okay, a tsconfig, which is a compiler configuration. We are including all the files, excluding node modules, and compiling all the TypeScript code and putting that in the output directory dist. So dist will have our final output code. And these are just the library and compiler configurations. So now we have our base NestJS based express TypeScript template. Similarly, you can also create a NestJS template with a basic configuration where it is talking to your MySQL. Okay, with the typeorm modules, you can set up a basic config module, database module, logger module, and some simple user module, and write a simple CRUD operation that we will talk in the next video.